Hey everyone, Eric here from Iowa Robot Fighting. So this last weekend we went to the WRC 2023 robot fighting qualifier for the MRCA this year. I'd like to report that things went well, but they really didn't. So at very least, it is a learning experience for us, and I have some really good takeaways. But the robots didn't exactly do as well as I had hoped. Luckily, this is the beginning of the season. Still time to make plenty of changes, but it's definitely less than optimal results. But one of the major problems before we even got there was Evan was supposed to come with Maelstrom. And before we even got the chance to leave, he was positive with COVID, so he wasn't able to attend, so we didn't bring Maelstrom with. I ended up registering What the Deuce in his spot instead, which my son Damien got his first chance to fight in a robot fighting competition and also scored his first victory in an official competition, which was awesome. He came away with a really good experience. Him only being, just going on 7 years old now, he's six right now. The fight that he had versus Antmine, which was against another young competitor, he had just barely practiced with my robot, Bad Touch, before the competition. And Ava, the driver of Antmine, she's quite young. She did really well. She's improved quite a lot over the last 2 years. She's actually one that we fought against in her early years. Damien and Ava kind of had a chaotic sort of fight. Damien didn't end up coming out on top. Ava ended up winning with Antmine, which congratulations to her. She made it quite a ways in the competition. But to get Deuce up and running, we actually had to buy motors on site, the N20 motors, which are these little tiny motors that I showed you, I think last week, that we upgraded away from on all of our other bots. The N20s are not easily controlled. They don't have a lot of pushing power. They move a bot just fine, but they're not great for people who are just getting into the sport, really. And Damien is by far a complete beginner and needs a lot of practice. So we learned that these motors are really difficult for him to handle, but they're the only ones that would fit in Deuce. We then moved on to his first win. He actually fought against the guy who gave us the motors, or actually we bought them off of, Brendan. Brendan, thank you for providing us those motors. And I'm sorry your design didn't work out as well as you'd expected, but I think, you know, creative designs like that are awesome. I can't wait to see it fully up and running. So Brendan had a very interesting design using gyroscopic precession as his movement. It was a full body spinner, or at least a ring spinner, I believe. Once it spun up, he used the lever action of a lifter underneath the robot to move the robot progressively towards different directions. However, it didn't quite work out the way he'd expected, and it had a lot of jamming or whatever, and Damien was able to get under him a couple of times, and then it was called by knockout, mostly because of malfunctions in that robot itself. But Damien racked up his first win there. Then he ended up with his final loss against another control bot, who was much better controlled than Damien, mostly down to just the age of the competitors. He, I believe, was in his 20s, had enough RC experience. It was his first time at a competition as well. But the difference in age makes a big difference when you're talking about a 20-year-old versus, say, a 6-year-old. So Damien has a lot of practice ahead of him. We need to build a bot that's specific to his skill set, and get him some experience that way. I don't know if we're going to go with an active weapon for him at all, or whether we're going to go with a control bot design. That'll take some playing around, But, you know, it'll be interesting as we go forward. So let's get into my fights. I'll show you a quick highlight reel right here. So, you can't really tell from the fights themselves, but I'll get into the individual little details that were good and bad about the about Bad Touch. So, the overall concept, I believe, is solid. I think it's a good route to go. I don't see any major glaring issues like there were in some of the last Cowboy builds. It all came down to minor changes that need to be made and process changes that need to be made in how I set up for fights. So let's get into the reasons, the individual changes that need to be made in the robot. So right now it's a little too back heavy. Every time I would move forward in an extreme amount of speed to try and capitalize on a good hit with my main weapon, my front end would lift up, causing me to go above a lot of my opponents with my weapon and sometimes end up on the front wedge of my opponent. My first fight was against Flip. Now, Flip was one of the top control bots. He had really great bot handling skills. The bot was really strong. Being my first fight with Bad Touch, it just was not going my way. I just couldn't get the weapon up to speed. He had dominated that fight from the very beginning, and that was a mix between my lack of confidence in the robot and lack of practice, and some minor issues that I was having with the robot itself. With that, there was some major issues with control. My second fight was against Jack the Donkey, which was Ashley's bot. I thought I had a really good chance of winning this one. And during the fight, there was actually a moment where he charged me, and my weapon was spun up at the time, and it hit. His wedge hit against my main weapon, and my weapon actually deflected Ashley's bot. It was pretty much the ideal situation, but not more than a couple of seconds afterwards, the weapon died entirely, which gets into my process changes. So there's a lot of things. I actually have a running list of things that need to be checked. From what you can see in this picture right here, there was actually a disconnected control cable to my ESC, which caused my weapon to shut down. It actually fired back up when I picked up my robot. I could hear it fire up. So I ended up having to power it down, did some checks, and in my test box, I could hear the intermittent power of my weapon occurring. So I changed out the ESC and it worked just fine, but I was already done with my fights. So it comes down to, I need to check all my connections and solder points. I need to do a spin-up check in the test box beforehand. I need to have all my batteries charged and balanced, and I need to ensure that my radio is on the presets. Every time I got into a fight, because I was using one radio for two robots, I kept changing the presets and it slowed down the fights. Wasn't exactly great because I had to do a quick setup change. And then during the assembly, I need to not use old parts. I was using the same ESC. It's an ESC I've had for over a year. And I knew it worked during testing. You guys saw it run. It's the same ESC I had when I was testing Bad Touch here, but apparently it suffered enough damage that eventually it just let loose. I need to replace any wiring that is fraying or I can see exposed wires on. That can cause shorts. I had that happen up in Minneapolis. And I need to Loctite every screw connection that I have. That needs to be the process every time for assembly and pre-fight. But when it came down to it, I decided that I really wanted to get another fight in. I hadn't been able to see the bot in action completely. I didn't know what needed to be changed really at this point. I just knew I messed up. So I was able to line up a fight against Antmine, and which was a really good choice because Antmine was one of the strongest. We had a couple others that wanted to jump in with fairy weight bots just to see them get kicked around. And one was actually a hex bug battle bot, which was kind of funny. And we had some fun kicking each other around, and I got to test my bot against Antmine and honest to God battle damage at that point. And so I was able to find out that there's a minor issue with my weapon. So on the axle, there was actually some slippage that occurred for the weapon and the drive wheel. And the reason this happened was because the set screw wasn't strong enough to keep it from sliding. And that's not ideal. That's not going to do me any good. The solution that I plan to implement, because this is a quarter inch aluminum axle, is I intend to put a small hole through the axle and use cotter pins top and bottom. So one here and one down at the bottom here to hold my axle in place, or to hold my hubs in place so that I don't get any slippage. Because once I had, you know, a quarter inch of slippage, the weapon was then flying up over the top of Antmine and wasn't making any contact. So that's one major issue. The other thing I noticed was that my weapon wasn't spinning nearly as fast as some of the other bots. That could be down to a variety of reasons, one of which is I'm running a wheel against the outside of my motor for my Brazilian drive system. That is causing a gear ratio of about 2 to 1 for my weapon spin up, which means I technically have more torque to spin up my weapon to full speed faster. But the problem comes down to that it's not going to have as much velocity on impact. So I might want to reduce the size of the Brazilian drive wheel. That could help a little bit. But the other problem is that there's quite a lot of friction. The fact that I'm not using any bearings or bushings for this axle causes that motor to have a lot more resistance. So that's probably where I'll start. I'm going to upgrade the system to running some bearings now instead of just against the raw openings. So I've got to order those special, but that should allow for a much more stable weapon system at the very least. I'll try that first, and that way I don't have to change over the overall design. That's pretty much it, other than the fact that I need to tune the controls to be able to have more fine control when I'm going up against control bots. There was a time where when my weapon was down up against Jack the Donkey, I was able to pin Jack the Donkey, but because I didn't have the fine control, I wasn't able to do it again. Every time I tried to turn, I always oversteered the robot. So that'll take some fine adjustment and a lot of practice. For me, the next thing is to make some adjustments, but before that, I will be going up against Maelstrom. Evan and I will have a series of bouts here to get him some practice, because I know that my bot can hold up against against impacts. I have plenty of spare parts, and we have 3 to 4 months before we need to be ready for the next fight. So Evan needs to be prepared for that since he missed out on this one. So the other thing is, I thought the WRC this year was run very smoothly. Everything went better than I could have expected. There's been some major improvements made to their process and how they go about running things. They really tightened things down. And Joseph Betts, the operator of WRC, I reached out to him to thank him for putting on such a great event. And he wanted me to thank the sponsors and volunteers. So he said that without the volunteers that he had, the event wouldn't have nearly gone as smooth, and it's all down to them. So on screen right now, thank you guys. You did a great job. Keep up the good work. I hope you guys stay involved for next year and later this year when we run the finals for the MRCA. It was a great event, and keep up the good work. Joseph wanted me to thank the sponsors. So he'd like me to thank RFA Engineering, Palm Beach Bots, Repeat Robotics, and Betts Robots, which I believe Betts Robots is them. So thank you all for the sponsorships. I know without you guys, we only would have had one arena, because at least one of the sponsors actually donated enough to be able to get that arena, the additional arena that was needed. So thank you so much. So to essentially recap what all happened, it was less than optimal for the IRF this time around. WRC went great, and Evan wasn't able to participate, but my son Damien ended up with his first win ever. So, you know, a mixed bag of results, but we have stuff to act on, and there's a lot more to come in this season. So you guys be safe out there, and I will see you next time.